Good morning, students. Sai Ram. Today in English we are going to do a poem. The name of the poem is Mist by P.G. Wodehouse. Now the title itself is telling you children that something is missing or missed out, right? So you all are missing your school days presently. Yes. So let's see what is the poet talking about. Before we start with the poem, let's have a brief introduction of the poet. P.G. Wodehouse, from 1881 to 1975, is one of the most widely read humorists of the 20th century. He is also known for his novels and short stories and also for his unique style of writing. Then some of his famous works include Something Fresh, Piccadilly Jim and Thank You, Jeeves. So this was a brief introduction of the poet. Now children, everybody likes to play games, right? Sports, playing games, especially outdoor games, they keep us physically fit, right? So have you ever lost a game due to someone's or your own negligence? Yes, just some silly mistake has happened and you lose the game. Now, what is the spirit when you start with the game? Yes, everybody wants to win the game. Yes, everybody likes to win the game. And suppose if any mistake happens, either from you or by your friend, then you start blaming. Oh, why did I do that mistake? Otherwise, the game would be ours. Then otherwise, you blame your friend. It's because of you that we have lost the game. Yes, because everybody likes to win the game. Even if we play snake and ladder, we want to win that game, right? So, what are the essential qualities that make a good sportsman? Yes, so a good sportsman should be dedicated, devotional towards his game, and also should be more concentration is required. Okay, so what is most important is when you play a game, you need to put your whole self, your full concentration in the game if you want to win the game. Even a minor mistake will lose your game, right? So, let's see what the poet is telling us about. Now, what can you see on your screen? Yes, cricket kid. All are happy to see, right? Especially the boys. Yes, but now cricket is played by girls also, correct? Yes. Now, this is a cricket player with all his cricket equipments and also the dress. What is this dress called as? Yes, it is called as flannels. Now, what can you see in this picture? Yes, there are children playing on the ground. And you can see the ball is already thrown and everybody's attention is there on the ball. That means what is he going to do? Whether he's going to catch the ball or whether he's going to lose the catch. So everybody's attention is there on the game, on the ball. So we that much concentration is required. Even the batsman is worried. Oh, now what will happen? Whether the ball will be caught by that fellow. Yes, he's a fielder. And so everybody, even the batsman and the other team players, they are just watching at it. So that is an interest is created, right? We all are eager to know what is going to happen, how many wickets are going to go. Yes, so then that will get to know. Yes, now from so far what I was telling you all, it must be very clear that the poem is related to cricket game. Yes, so let's read the poem. The sun in the heavens was beaming, the breeze bore an odor of hay. My flannels were spotless and gleaming, my heart was unclouded and gay. The ladies, all gaily apparelled, sat round looking on at the match. In the treetops the dicky birds carolled, all was peace till I bungled that catch. So now the poet is describing over there what was the situation. So it was a sunny day. Was a summer day and harvest season. That is why in the breeze the poet could feel that odor. He could smell that odor of harvest, of that hay. That means there would be, the stadium is somewhere close to the land area of cultivation. Okay, and so he could smell that odor of rice and wheat fields, right, the hay. My flannels were spotless and gleaming, my heart was unclouded and gay. So his flannels, see here the meanings are also given, children. Flannel means white clothes worn by a cricketer. We have already seen it in the screen. Unclouded, not worried. So his flannel that he had wore was shining and gleaming, and it was spotless. And at the same time, his heart was unclouded and gay. Unclouded means he was full of no worries. He was relaxed. Okay, he had no tension about the game and was very happy. Okay, the ladies all gaily apparelled sat round looking on at the match. So all the ladies, apparel means dressed, and they were nicely dressed up and sitting in the stadium to watch the match. In the treetops the dicky birds carolled all peace till I bungled that catch. So on the treetops there were small birds. What do you mean by carol? They sang cheerfully and all was peace. So the atmosphere was very peaceful and till I bungled that catch. And what was the mess done by the poet? Bungled means mess up. So something was messed up by the poet and all that atmosphere was spoiled. That peace in the atmosphere was spoiled. Now let's see in the next stanza what does he say. My attention, the magic of summer, had lured from the game which was wrong. The bee, that invertebrate hummer, was droning its favorite song. I was tenderly dreaming of Clara, on her not a girl is a patch. When, horror, there soared through the air a decidedly possible catch. So what is the poet telling? Bungled, I told you, means to mess up. Invertebrate is persistent. Droning, buzzing. Decidedly is definitely. So what is the poet saying? My attention, the magic of summer, had lured from the game which was wrong. So the poet's attention was diverted from the game because of that climate, the atmosphere over there. Okay? And so his attention was diverted. The bee, that invertebrate hummer. So there were bees who were droning continuously, was droning its favorite song. The buzzing sound of the bees he could hear, and he could not stop himself from diverting his attention towards the nature, and because of which he did a mess in the game. I was tenderly dreaming of Clara, on her not a girl is a patch. And he was dreaming of Clara. Now Clara, according to him, is a girl who is most beautiful for him. When horror, there soared through the air a decidedly possible catch. And then there he could hear a horror from the audience side. And what was that? Because they felt it was a definite catch, but it was missed out by the poet because his attention was diverted from the game, right? So this is what he had done while playing the game. I heard in a stupor the bowler emit a self-satisfied ah. The small boys who sat on the roller set up an expectant hooray. The batsman with grief from the wicket himself had begun to detach. And I uttered a groan and turned sick. It was over. I had buttered the catch. Now, droning means the buzzing sound. Decidedly means definitely, as I told you before. Then stupor is daze and buttered means missed. So what is the poet telling? I heard in a stupor the bowler emit a self-satisfied ah. So somewhere behind his conscious mind he has heard somebody saying ah. That means the bowler, because he had thrown the catch and he was very sure that it would be caught by him and he would get a wicket. So the bowler was, he seemed to be happy that, okay, now he will catch it and I'll get the wicket. The small boys who sat on the roller sat up and expected hooray. So even the boys who were sitting in the stadium, they were happy. And they were like, hooray, we are going to win the match, right? The batsman with grief from the wicket himself had begun to detach. Now the batsman was also worried. He also seemed to be worried, like he is going to lose the match. Okay, he will have to leave the pitch now because the ball is going to be caught by the poet. And I uttered a groan and turned sick. It was over. I had buttered the catch. So, and what did the poet did? He was very sad because he had missed the catch. And there the game was completely spoiled because the catch was slipped from his hand. Yes, so that is what, see children, any game, if you miss out a concentration, if you just divert your mind even for a fraction of a second, anything can happen. So you need to be very much attentive, right? Yes, so now we will just stop here for today, and the next part of the poem will continue in our next class. Now we'll just do a comprehension and let's see how much we have understood. The sun in the heavens was beaming, the breeze bore an odor of hay, my flannels were spotless and gleaming, my heart was unclouded and gay. The ladies, all gaily apparelled, sat round looking on at the match. In the treetops the dicky birds carolled, all was peace till I bungled that catch. Now let's answer some questions based on the extract. Who sat round looking on at the match? So who sat round? The ladies sat round looking at the match. Which match is being referred in the poem? So which match is the poet talking about? Yes, a cricket match is being referred in the poem. What was the narrator wearing? The narrator was wearing spotless flannels. Who carolled on the treetops? The dicky birds carolled on the treetops. Give two pairs of rhyming words from the poem. It is beaming, gleaming, match, catch. So children, we shall stop here for today. We'll continue with the next part in our next class. Till then, thank you.